Have you ever wished you could see the future, discover the secrets of the universe, or perhaps predict next week's lottery numbers? Well, I can't promise you that, unfortunately. But what if I told you that there is an AI tool that seems just as magical, and only the elite 1% know it even exists? Hey, I'm unveiling the secret. Prepare to have your mind blown. I've all seen AI in action, but nothing like this before. The advanced data analysis tool in GPT-4, powered by OpenAI's large language model, is truly out of this world. It's pretty simple. You input your own business data set, and now we are talking to Einstein, but about your own data. Experts think that this tool could eventually replace data scientists and analysts. I don't think so myself, but that's a different topic for a different video. So now I know what you're thinking. That seems too good to be true. But seeing is believing. So let's walk the talk and let me show you GPT-4 Advanced Data Analysis Tool in action. I'm gonna be showing you three amazing demos that will blow your mind away. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so right now we are in ChatGPT homepage, and you can see that you can either select ChatGPT or GPT 3.5 model. And this is our fastest model, great for most everyday tasks. Or you can go ahead and select GPT-4 instead. Think of GPT-4 as an advanced version of ChatGPT. It's a lot more powerful, and it can unlock advanced reasoning capabilities. So please note that you will need to have ChatGPT Plus, which is the premium, basically, version, which is around $20 per month as we speak right now, to be able to activate GPT-4 and activate as well the advanced data analysis tool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to here to the settings and beta, and then I'm going to select beta features, and I'm going to activate or enable the advanced data analysis tool. So if you just enable it, and here it's going to tell you, well, try a version of ChatGPT that knows how to write and execute Python code, and it can work with uploads as well. So now I can upload a file, for example, an Excel sheet, and now I can talk to the Excel sheet. I can do financial statement analysis. I can also do data visualization. I can do many, many things as well. So now I'm activated it. This looks good. Now if I go to GPT-4, you can see advanced data analysis tool. So if you just click on it right now, now you can see there is a plus sign that appeared on the bottom left corner. So now you can ChatGPT can right now accept an Excel sheet or to upload a file essentially. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to say attach file, and you can just click on it here. And now I'm gonna upload the Amazon CSV file here. Let me show it to you. So if you right click on it and you say open, that is going to open Amazon stock price data. And here is the Excel sheet that I'm going to upload. So the Excel sheet contains multiple columns. It simply contains the date information. It can also has here the open price. It has the high price, the low as well. The closing price has also the number of shares that have been traded, the volume. And it also had the adjusted closing price. And this is simply the price after you account for dividends and for stock splits. Don't worry about it. Here, I just wanted to show you the data set. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload this sheet. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select Amazon sheet. And here we go. Now you can see Amazon.csv has been uploaded essentially to our ChatGPT. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to start typing. And I'm going to say, could you please display the first 5 rows that we got in the data? So now you are essentially talking to an Excel sheet. Okay, so here we go. So now what is going to happen is ChatGPT or GPT-4 is going to call or run a Python script for you, and it's going to show you the data. Look how amazing or incredible that is. So now you can see the date, you can see the open price, high, low, close, volume, and adjusted close as well. If you'd like to show code or show work, if you click on show work here, now you can see all the different code scripts. So now it imported pandas, it checked out or kind of read the CSV file, and now you can see the date, open, high, low, and you can just use .head method to visualize or view the first 5 rows that we got in the data. Pretty incredible. And what I'm going to do next is I would like to plot. I'm going to say, could you please plot the closing price versus date? And now, instead of just writing code or typing code to visualize your data, now you can just write a prompt to do that for you. You can just say, could you please show me the closing price versus date? And here we go. Now you can see ChatGPT or GPT-4 actually plotting curves for you, which is pretty kind of incredible. To me, it's out of this world, I would say. Please note that this is still in beta version. This is just the beginning, the start. Imagine what GPT-7 will look like with this data analysis tool. And here we go. Now we can see the closing price versus the date information. What if I want it maybe to see if it understands or kind of is robust enough? So I'm going to say, could you please plot the volume versus date? So if I say plot the volume versus date, now it's going to hopefully it will understand that I would like to grab the volume column versus the date column and plot it on the x-axis versus y-axis. And here we go. Now you can see the volume information versus date information. And then finally, what if I wanted to plot both of them on one graph? So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say plot the closing price versus date and volume also versus date using subplots. So subplot is simply a plot that includes two plots in it. And here we go. Let's go ahead and see if that works. So now it's working. And of course, you can go ahead, you can run code. And now you can see that it's calling a library called matplotlib. And now it just simply plotted the date versus volume. And here it showed the volume versus date. And you can also see that the legend has shown here as well. And a title as well has been shown, volume versus date information. And here we go. Now you can see basically both of them have been plotted on the same graph or in the same plot. It didn't fully understand that this is subplot, but that's okay. It's just plotted both of them on the same plot. And that's pretty much it. That's all I have for this first demo. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you liked this demo so far. Let me show you the second demo right away. All right, so the second demo that I would like to show you is how you can use GPT-4 to perform financial statement analysis. So now GPT-4 is gonna wear the hat of a financial analyst and do income statement analysis for us. So the question is, okay, where is the data? And please note that I'm going to include the data in the description of that YouTube video. If you click on attach files, and then you need to upload the file. Here I included income statement for Apple from 2018 up until 2022. So now if you just click on it, that is going to upload the income statement for us. And let me show you the income statements as well. So if you actually open the Excel sheet, I'm going to open it here for you. And the Excel sheet will include all the, here we go. Now you can see the revenues for Apple. You can see the cost of goods sold. You can also see the gross profit as well. You can also see the R&D expenses or research and development expenses. You can also see SG&A or selling general and admin expenses as well. You can also see the pre-tax income, income after taxes. You can also see here the basic shares outstanding and number of outstanding shares as well from 2018 up until 2022. So now I'm going to upload that sheet to GPT-4. And then I want to see if GPT-4 is able to understand and analyze that data for us. So now the first question that I'm going to ask is, could you please calculate for me the earnings per share for Apple for year 2022? And here we go. Let's go ahead. And please note that I calculated this before and the correct answer is 6.11. And here we go. Earnings per share is equal to net income divided by number of outstanding shares. And just look at GPT-4, just typing equations, you know, as if it's a financial analyst for you or a mathematician, for example. It's going to tell you, well, net income for 2022, I need the number of outstanding shares for 2022. And now it's calling Python code behind the scenes. It's a financial analyst who knows Python, who knows how to visualize data. He knows even finance because it has been trained on the entire internet. Here we go. Now it's telling you the net income is $99 billion. Number of outstanding shares is 16 billion. And now if you take these values and you divide them together, you should end up hopefully with 6.11. And hopefully that should, it's telling you that there is an error here that has been, and that's kind of one of the good features of GPT-4 Advanced Data Analysis Tool, that it can actually learn that it made mistakes and now it can try to correct itself afterwards. And please note that this is again still in beta version. And just imagine, again, when it's the full release of that version or that tool appears. And of course, with advanced, here we go. So now you can see the earnings per share for year 2022 is approximately 6.11, assuming currency is in dollars. Great job, GPT-4. Okay, the second question is very generic question. And I'm going to, we learned how to do that before. But let me show it to you here. I'm going to say, could you please plot the gross profit versus years? And let's see what's going to happen here. So hopefully it will be able to plot as well financial data for us. It's going to take some time to run that Python code behind the scenes. And it's extracting the data. And here we go. Amazing. So now you can see the gross profit and how the growth of the gross profits just happened over the years from 2020, 2021, and then 2022 afterwards. Okay, pretty incredible. Next one, I'm going to would like to perform, and that's kind of more of a general question, perform data analysis on the income statement for Apple Inc. And let's see what kind of analysis, for example, that GPT-4 is going to do for us. It's going to tell you, well, I'm going to analyze the revenue growth. I'm going to analyze as well the gross profit margin. I'm going to analyze as well the operating profit margin too. And here it's calculating for you, like what the gross profit margin is, what the operating profit margin is, net profit margin as well. And it's kind of typing equations, writing that analysis. Hopefully we'll see the trend over the year. And let's see. It's generating as well the output. So here we let's calculate and analyze these metrics. So these are the metrics that GPT-4 is going to analyze for us based on the financial data or the income statement that we uploaded for Apple. And it's taking some time for it to run and execute right now. And here we go. Now you can see the revenue growth, for example, is telling you between 2018 and 2019, it's talking as if there is a financial analyst behind the scenes. There was indicating a decline, there was negative, and then there was a most significant drop between 2019 and 2020 with a decrease of approximately 25%. However, there was a recovery between 2020 and 2021. The revenue growth further increased to 2022. Let's talk about the gross profit margin, the operating profit margin, the year-over-year growth, and it's kind of talking, kind of understood right now, the data, and it's writing a conclusion for you about the financial health of Apple, the performance and trend, the operating efficiency, and again, it's kind of, to me, this is out of this world because it can shift between becoming generic data scientist to becoming a financial analyst, and that's kind of the conclusion for the second demo. I hope you enjoyed it, and let's meet in the third demo. All right, so the third example that I wanted to show you is now I'm going to ask GPT-4 Advanced Data Analysis Tool to become an AI engineer or a machine learning engineer and actually train machine learning models for us. And this is the scary part. It's an AI that is training another AI to solve specific machine learning real world problems. So let's go ahead and get started. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to upload another data set, and this data set is going to be for the house prices data. So here I have the house data, and the house prices data is simply data that real estate agents can actually use. So here I have the square foot, for example, of the house. I have whether the house is waterfront or not. I also have additional features such as the longitude, the latitude, and so on. And then I have the output from that model, and that is going to be the house price. And I'm trying to predict the house price given all these different features of a house. How many bedrooms, how many bathrooms, and so on. So what I'm going to do right now is I wanted to first visualize the data, and let me go ahead and actually open the data for you. So if you open the house price data, and again, the data is included in the description. So here we go. House, number of bedrooms, square foot of the living. You can also see the square foot above. You can see the year built. You can also, so basically all of this here, all of these different columns, all of these are inputs. And this price here is the output from my model. So I want to train an AI that can take all these inputs and then tell me what the price will look like. And this is kind of, we can use it as a real estate agent to value properties. So the first prompt that I'm going to do right now is I'm going to ask GPT-4 to obtain a statistical summary about the data. So basically here, I just wanted to see the average, the standard deviation. I want to see the minimum and maximum value of pretty much every column that I got in the data. And let's see if that works. Here we go. Now it was able to read the data. It's going to tell you the data seems to contain information about various houses. So it understood what that data includes. It includes information such as number of bedrooms, bathrooms, and so on. Now you can see statistical summary about the data. You can see the number of bedrooms. You can see the count. You can see the mean, standard deviation, min, max, and 75th percentile as an example. You can see the number of bathrooms. You can see the count, the mean, the standard deviation. And it's going to tell you as well additional other columns if you'd like to view that. And it's going to tell you the data set contains 21,000 house entries. The average price for house is approximately $500,000. The most expensive house is $7.7 million, while the cheapest one is $75,000, and so on. Looks pretty amazing. The next one is I would like to go ahead and visualize the data. So I'm going to say, could you please visualize the data for me? And let's see if the advanced data analysis tool is able to do that for us. It's going to tell you, well, I can do many things. I can do box plot. I can do histograms. I can do scatter plot. I can do bar plot. Let's start with these visualizations. So let's go ahead and get started. So now it's running a Python code behind the scenes, and it's going to generate these visuals for us. And here we go. Now we can see simply the visuals for multiple. So it actually plotted kind of a mix of all these different visuals. So for example, here you can see the distribution of house prices. This is the histogram. You can also see here the box plot for the number of bedrooms versus the price. You can also see here the square foot of the living versus the price. You can see that as the square foot of the living tend to increase, the house price tend to increase as well. You can also see here the number of houses with and without waterfront view. So a lot of the houses, obviously they are not waterfront, and this is kind of the majority of houses. You can also see here the distribution of the house, the box plot, scatter plot, kind of explaining for you all these different visualizations for us. Okay, let's assume that I would like to plot the correlation matrix. So I'm going to say, could you please plot the correlation heat map? This is simply a matrix that can show all the different correlations between features. So here we go. Now, hopefully it will see, it's explaining to you first that if you find positive one, that means positive correlation. Minus one, that means negative correlation. Zero, that means no correlation. And now it's generating that heat map for us. Hopefully it will gonna work. Let's see if it generated the output for us or not, the expected one. Oh, amazing, out of this world again. So now you can see GPT-4 kind of visualizing a heat map for you. And it's kind of can show you the price, and you can see there is a strong positive correlation between the square foot of the living and the price. And here we go, there is a strong positive correlation at 0.7 between the house prices and the space of the living, which makes sense. As the space tend to increase, house prices tend to increase as well. You can also see additional features here and show you all the correlations between features. Okay, finally, and this is kind of the last prompt that I'm going to end this video with, is could you please train a machine learning regression model to predict the price for us? So now I wanted an AI to train another AI to try to predict the house prices given all these different inputs. So it is going to tell you I'm going to do data processing, I'm going to do model selection, I'm going to train the model, and then I'm going to evaluate the model as well. And hopefully let's see if it works or not. And I tested all these different prompts before and it has been very robust. It actually worked pretty much every time, which is pretty amazing. And here we go. Now it's telling you that we split the data into training and testing, and this is very normal. We wanted to train the model on the training set. And once the model is trained, we are going to evaluate the model performance on an independent or testing data set. And here we go. So it split it to, and here we go. Now it trained the machine learning model and it's actually generating metrics as well. It's going to tell you, well, the mean absolute error is 127,000. The mean squared error of 45, this is actually a very large number, but don't worry about it for now. You can see here the R squared at 0.7. So that means 70% of the variation in the output is being explained by the variation in the input. And this is actually a good sign. And you can see that now you have been able to train a machine learning model. Of course, you can try XGBoost algorithm. You can try deep neural networks. You can try many other algorithms as well. And that's pretty much it. That's all I have for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like it, all I want you to do is to please just hit the like button. That's all I want. And of course, if you need more videos, please don't, please go ahead and try to consider subscribing to the channel. Please stay tuned. Best of luck, and I'll see you in future videos.